All right. So I specifically chose this thumb to show you some importance of a particular topic we learned in our school, but probably never appreciated that. How many of you remember coordinate geometry you learned in school? Why did we need to study coordinate geometry after you had a 10-year-long course on geometry? Not 10-year-long course, maybe it started from class 7. So 4-year-long course in geometry. Why did we need to go for that coordinate geometry? Understand this thing. Throughout this course, throughout this BSc Mathematics Honors course, I will be asking you that why do we need to study something, okay? And also for the new topics, I will be giving you this answer. You are, let me tell you very clearly, get this very straight, that you are also allowed to ask this question to any teacher from now on, that why do we need to study a particular topic? And let me tell you very clearly, that answer to that question must never be that it is because it is there in your syllabus. Everything what you will study has some purpose in the mathematics, in the literature of mathematics. That is why those things are there in your syllabus. The reason that why do you need to study a particular topic, the answer to this question, this is a very valid question, very much valid question, and the answer to this question must not be just because it is there in your syllabus. Okay, so you are allowed to ask this question to everybody. So now I am interested at what purpose did coordinate geometry serve over than the plane geometry? That is the question. The answer to this question is this example. Let me put coordinates on this one. Now, this is the answer. CD and BE are medians intersecting at F. They are medians. So F must be centroid, right? So the formula for centroid is the sum, the average of the three coordinate x coordinates and the average of three y coordinates. So 0 plus 18 plus 0 over 3, that is the x coordinate. So x1 plus x2 plus x3 by 3, y1 plus y2 plus y3 by 3. So then if the median is 6,6, so therefore this triangle FDB, the height is this y coordinate of this point F. So height is 6, this is base is 9, so half into 6 into 9, that is 27. Now, after you see this sum, can you recomment on why do we need coordinate geometry to make our lives easier? That's it. Plane geometry has got many results, many beautiful results, and placed with extremely beautiful arguments. Okay, to make the things easier for us, we went for coordinate geometry. That is the reason. We do coordinate geometry over plane geometry, just to make sums easier. Let me tell you a background story to this one. When I first encountered this sum, I was in class 12. I still remember it was I usually study at night. So when I got this question, I was doing this sum on a winter night. I was wrapped inside a shawl, warm shawl, and did not want to take out my hand from inside the shawl. I knew that the way you guys have tried with that elaborate geometric process, I will be able to find the result. But since it is too long process, I did not want to do that. So I just sort of sat inside my shawl, just looking at this one, and maybe say thinking about 15-20 minutes, I could imagine about the coordinates of these points. And I could do it. I could find the result without taking the pen in my hand, without any calculation. See, the calculation is extremely easy, right? So it is 0180000180, so this is the centroid, and once you identify this is the centroid, so this must be 6,6, sum of the x coordinates divided by 3, sum of the y coordinates divided by 3, so this height will be 6, and this this base will be 9, so half into 6 into 9, that is 7, 27, that's it. No need to, I mean, you can do the entire calculation in your mind only. So this is what I meant by when I said the other day in that being lazy. In mathematics honors, in sometimes you need to be lazy to find out a more effective solution. Lazy means in this way. In a chilly winter night, I do not want to take out my hand from inside the warm shawl. So you use your brain to do the calculations so that you do not have to take out your hand from inside the shawl. So you think of it this way, you thought of it maybe say 15-20 minutes, doesn't matter, no problem. So, and you get this result without any calculation, any big calculation needed on the paper. So this is sort of a motivation for you to look at things, try to look at things from other perspectives. This will be very much needed in your course. All right. Now, so this is the backstory to this one. And you are allowed a sort of a little bit encouraged to be lazy in this way. So lazy in terms of your physical activity in a chilly winter night, and not in terms of your brain. You use your brain to your full potential as you can, and try to reduce your physical activity. That is the whole idea about behind technology. We mix algebra with geometry in coordinate geometry. Now, how do we essentially do that? What do you understand of a locus? You heard about this term locus in coordinate geometry, right? In your second chapter, locus is a path traced by a point under certain conditions. Locus is path. Let me write it over here. Can you all see my screen? Locus is a path traced by a moving point under certain conditions. This is what is meant by locus. So, for example, for a circle, the condition is of being or remaining equidistant from a fixed point. So this is the condition for a circle. Now, when I write this one, that x square plus y square is equals to a square. Okay, so locus of a circle is locus of a circle with center at 0,0. At 0,0 and radius a is this one. So when we say this one, locus of a circle is circle with center at 0,0, center at 0,0 and radius a is this one. How do we make the relation between this circle, this geometric form, circle, this geometric figure, and this algebraic relation x square plus y square equal to a square? This is the main idea about locus. Locus is the first thing. So by definition, locus is a path traced by a moving point under certain conditions. So this one does not say under which conditions, under geometric conditions or under algebraic conditions. So for a circle, the condition is of being equidistant from a fixed point. This geometric conditions gives us this nice looking shape, nice looking figure in the plane, in the two-dimensional plane. Also, we write that locus of a circle with center at 0, 0 and radius a is x square plus y square equals to a square. So how do we relate this algebraic equation with this geometric figure? Can you, there are two descriptions of the locus here. This one, the highlighted one right now, is a geometric description, and this one is an algebraic description. Do you agree? Now my question is, how do we relate this equation, this algebraic equation, with this geometric figure? This relation, this association of an algebraic equation with the geometric description is the crux of coordinate geometry. This is how we do in coordinate geometry. So I am now currently now addressing the question, how do we deal with things in coordinate geometry? How do we associate geometric figures with algebraic quantities? So this is what you have done so far, right? You had a geometric object and you represented that by some algebraic equation. A parabola you have represented by y square equal to 4ax equation. An ellipse you have represented by the algebraic equation x square by a square plus y square by b square equals to 1. Right? So does this association happen? How does a geometric figure represented by this algebraic equation? Understand this thing very carefully. That by this statement, locus of a circle with center at 0, 0 and radius a is x square plus y square is equal to a square, we mean this. This denotes the collection of points x comma y in the two dimensional plane, so that x square plus y square is equals to a square. That is in such notation we have this. Okay, so xy is in the two dimensional plane. All those points in two-dimensional plane, x comma with coordinates x comma y, such that their coordinates are bound by this relation. So there are infinitely many solutions to this algebraic equation. This algebraic equation has got infinitely many solutions x comma y. And those points x comma y, if we plot on a graph paper, we will get this nice geometric object. So this is the association. Whenever we say locus of a circle is this, that means we are talking about this set, all those points in this set, such that the coordinates, those are algebraic quantities, these coordinates satisfy this algebraic equation x square plus y square is equals to a square, and there are infinitely many points of them. Those points, if we plot in the graph paper, then those points will look like this geometric figure. This is how we do things in coordinate geometry. If we take all the points x comma y, coordinates of all those points x comma y which satisfy the equation x y square is equal to 4ax, then we will get the parabola. This is the association I am talking about. That this is a completely geometric object, and this is completely an algebraic equation. How do we associate this algebraic equation with this geometric object? By this understanding, that this is the locus. This means all those points x comma y whose coordinates x and y, these are the coordinates of these points x and y, these points satisfy this algebraic equation, given algebraic equation x square plus y square is equals to a square. So then if we plot all these points on the graph paper, then we will get this geometric figure. So this is an algebraic condition. And this one over here was the geometric condition. This is how they are associated with each other. This condition If we translate this in terms of the coordinates of the moving point, then we will get the coordinates of that moving point will satisfy this algebraic equation. And by saying the locus of the circle is this algebraic equation, we mean to look at all those points which satisfy this given equation, x square plus y square equals to a square, and the collection of all of them will be this locus in the two-dimensional plane. And so we got answers to two questions today. Number one, why do we do coordinate geometry to make our life easier in terms of geometry? And secondly, how do we do it? How do we mix algebra with geometry? If we mix algebra with geometry, then there is one more thing, that algebra generalizes things, and in geometry also the generalization is much easier in that case. So the reason we do coordinate geometry is to make our life easier in terms studying geometry, and secondly we do it by this way. This is our way to associate algebra and geometry to do coordinate geometry to make our life easier in this way. This is your homework for today. For how many integer pairs x comma y, the equation x square minus y square is equal to 66 are satisfied. You need to find how many those pairs are possible. Integer pairs, x and y must be integers.